So we are here at the storage of the Heggedal layout. We put it there 1 year ago and I have already taken it out. It was stored in that corner. And it's soon the festival in 1 month. And last year we had to control the train manually and it was a very tiresome thing to do that for 4 hours. So automation it is. Since train AI was quite dumb and not ready, we are going to go the old fashioned way with feedback sensor in the tracks. So after putting all modules in place, it was time to isolate the different sections of track. On DC tracks, the detection is done by isolating a section of tracks and then measuring if a current flow is flowing. This is the case when a locomotive turns on the tracks or cars which have their wheels not completely isolated. On the hidden part of the layout, we use Trix C tracks. Isolating the tracks is easy. We just use our remaining Märklin C track isolator. Märklin and Trix C tracks are actually mechanically compatible. On this module, I had to move the feeder track as it was where I want to have the feedback section. First, we solder a wire to the outer track, which will be connected to the feedback module. Then we mount the isolator pieces. Then we screw the tracks back in place. For regular DC tracks, we just solder a piece of wire on the side. If you install this kind of big system from the beginning, it's better to solder the wire on the bottom of the track, so it's less visible. Then we use the Dremel to isolate the section. Each block requires at least 2 sections to work with Rocrail for the moment, which we are going to use for the moment. If you plan to use another software, check what I recommend. Then we add sections to each track in the shadow station. The two most inner tracks get a combination of both methods, with one side using C-track and the other normal flex track. When you isolate a section, always measure with a multimeter. It's easier to fix it now than later. After the shadow modules were completed, it was time to do the same with the visible modules. Here we have to be careful so the connections are not really visible. As we had quite some foam under the tracks, we could not directly drill through it, but had to make holes from both sides. For the station, we could repurpose some sections we already had feeder wires previously. Since the layout is transportable, we need to add connectors between the modules. That's not necessary on a fixed layout. If possible, you should have these connections on the side away from the viewers. We also found that the tracks were not carefully laid originally, so we had to remeasure everything. If the solder doesn't stick, Then you need to remove the paint from the tracks. Then it was time to install the feedback module. Since we have a Rocrail Z21 on this layout, we choose Arbus modules. Other command central have other buses like Loconet, S88 or CAN. And today Sven Magnus will install his first feedback module. So
this one?
Yes.
Yes. Let's try to keep it without disasters.
Yeah. So now that's something simple. We have to find a place for this from Modellbahn Electronic in Switzerland. So, and it costs half the price of the original Rocrail one.
Somewhere like yeah. this or?
Yes, you can like see that? How I did it. It doesn't matter what. Actually, that makes more sense.
Put it like that?
Yeah.
This one?
That's for the light okay. in the station. That's.
So it's not supposed to go to this one?
Okay, and now there is one has one more. Has a plug called power on one side. Yeah, the other, so on your left side.
Here, yeah.
This needs to go to the power, so it should be maybe you turn it around.
Like that, because it's to those?
Or? It needs to go to this.
Or that?
Yes. Yeah. Okay, now you, that's something for you. You know how to do that. Now you need to screw it in place.
Okay, so okay. installed.
Now you need to put a power cable to the module.
Okay, so that goes from there, to
either the top, which is a mess, or this one. Yeah. So you take these two. You don't need to solder, you can do it.
So no brown or black or red? You use yellow and green?
It's the same, we mix it because I didn't find the big cables in yellow one.
Okay, so somewhere like this.
Yeah. Actually, I'm doing that so long since I'm a kid, one of my teeth has formed the correct.
Okay, let's go again. Must be this one. Yeah.
Okay, so this goes into, you just choose one port.
So do I wire those on the inside of this? Yes, I think I do. Yeah. Like that. So and
doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter which one.
It needs to be. We need to put. We need to put one all in one group. So maybe put it in one.
Yeah. Because then everything will be crossed. Wire.
Yeah.
And I don't like that.
Okay. Okay.
Can it be number three?
You can put it number three. That's also logical.
Then it looks nicer, and my OCD will be happy.
Yeah.
Okay. It wasn't open.
I need to put it in again. Before you start, okay. Now we need a small cable which goes
to this one, was it?
Yes.
Which is.
Doesn't matter.
Okay, so those are both the same.
Yeah, so you can connect through to the next one. And now the next step, we have to connect the central, so the Z21, to the power, to this system. So the Z21 is now under the table. It's this white that box. One? Yes. Yeah. I just take it out. Take it closer. Okay. So now you put the power cable to the Vargo on the left side.
This.
It's power. It's off now.
Yeah, but what is?
No. It's just temporary.
But which is?
Doesn't matter. Uh-huh. Like I said, it's AC.
Okay.
Yeah.
So just.
Just in the. Oh, it's on the other side.
Yeah, of course. Like that. And like that.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
And now you take this RJ12 cable and you connect it to the Airbus.
Airbus?
Airbus. Air.
Airbus is an aircraft.
No, it's just air, not the RE in front. It's a bit longer because we will need to connect to the other module after.
So this goes from which one of these?
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
And if you go on the other end, it's German, it's Airbus.
Yeah.
I have the computer with the Z21 app. And now you press the button which says Verbinden. No, it's not a touchscreen. You have to use a mouse.
It worked?
It's a touchscreen? Oh. Okay, does it say something? Yes. So now.
Verbunden me.
Yes. It worked. And now you press on the top, there is a tab called Airbus.
Yes.
And now we need to program it. It's on the bottom.
Programmieren?
Yeah, now we need to turn it on first. So you press on the air, you turn the, is a button in front. Okay, so now it's on. Okay, now you see on the laptop,
There
is something called program. You need to put, because we have using module number one on the other one.
Yeah.
We have to put it to module number three because it contains two module. Okay. Because the way Rocco works, it's on the bottom.
So module address three?
Yes, address three in this case.
Three.
Yes. And now you press program.
Programmera.
Yeah. And now we will tell you to do something.
Trennans I samtliche module from
Z21
Airbus.
Now you, because next one, yeah.
Stecken Sie das zu programmieren.
Okay, now we have to connect only the module we want, not anything else. Because it's, okay, now next.
Okay.
Für eine Kabel.
Ja.
Und dann press OK. And now you set it back.
This one?
Yes. Okay. And now we have to put the thing flat. We have to put a locomotive on the tracks to see if it works.
Okay.
Put this one on.
Okay.
And I make the. Let's see if it works. We have light.
Okay.
Okay, we just need to clean the tracks maybe. Yeah. Okay. Now we have to see if on the computer it shows that it's on module 3.
Unfortunately, it didn't work yet. I found out afterwards that the Z21 doesn't just pull any address but seems to start at 1. If one is not present, it will stop. So after connecting module 1, isn't it to work? So you need to have all addresses in a range present, otherwise it won't work. Then it was just connecting the other sections to the feedback module. After checking the Z21 maintenance tool, I added all sections to the Z21 app. We found that some sections were not properly isolated, especially at the module border. So we used nail polish to put an isolating layer. To get automation, we have to use a control software. In this case, we use Rocrail because we already run it in the train room. but you can use another one of your choice. The principles are roughly the same. So first you will have to draw a plan for the layout. The Hegedal layout is pretty simple, basically a loop with two stations. We are not going into the details how to do that. Then you need to assign addresses to the switches as well as the feedback sections. Then we need to add the feedback sensor to the different blocks. When that is done, you can run the router, which generates all the different routes between the blocks. In our case, we need to add a block group, since we have a single line with two blocks and we need to avoid a deadlock. Then we add all the locomotive to the system and add one in the correct block where it stands. If we enable the automatic mode, then start a train and check that it runs properly around the layout. Since this is a realistic layout, we need to make sure that the train runs at the correct speed. So we use the Pico measurement card to match the actual speed to the system speed. As we have a 90s-20 seam, we run the train quite slow, as they were not that fast at the time. To avoid deadlocks and unforeseen situations, I decided to use timetables for the show. That way we could make sure that there is always a train coming at some point. It repeats every 10 minutes, so most visitors would not notice that, as they usually don't stay for that long. The system performed very well. The only problems were caused by poorly laid tracks on the original modules. So that's for this time. Maybe you want to watch the video in which we show how we constructed two of the modules.